Many shades of white in nature, from ivory to conch shells and jasmine flowers to ash, became associated with matters of faith and sacrifice and grew to be part of our living cultural tradition. White okora is the color of India and of the finest cotton grown in this land for thousands of years. The color chosen by Gandhiji for its mark of purity as the fabric of Swaraj. It is the color from which all other colors emerge, and for many, white marks the end of our journey on earth, or is it the beginning? The annual pilgrimage to the temple of Vithoba in Maharashtra.
When you go on that yatra, where there are what, 800,000 or 100,000 people, as you can see at one go, who are all wearing off-white and white. And it is the color of India.
A color that softens the cruel summer heat.
In any agricultural economy where people have to work in the fields, you reflect light, you do not absorb light. It's not very different from, say, stained glass in the West and the use of sheesh mahals or mirrors, which is much later, in the East. That's the primary reason for the use of white.
The poor wore coarse white cloth made from unbleached cotton or okora, which was inexpensive. The rich preferred fine muslins, but it was the light and breezy jamdani, woven in Dhaka in the east, Banaras in the north, and Tanjore and Upara in the south, which possessed the greatest beauty and reminded its lovers of white flowers, running water and moonlight.
When Aurangzeb's general was crossing a field of green, the villagers came up to him and said, "Please don't, you are destroying our lives." He said, "But don't you realize that there's cotton drying on the fields?" He thought it was mist. The reason for that is that we had short staple cotton fiber, so you could hand spin it much more easily and very finely. So this country produced cotton of 600 counts, which is the finest.
And everything else followed from it. The poet Mutribi Samarkandi described the Mughal Emperor Jahangir's flamboyant white darbars.
He describes them as, moonlit at midnight, and the entire court is dressed in white. The floors are laid with white carpets. All the courtiers wear white turbans, white robes. The emperor is dressed in white, and he's seated on a white throne. And there's one line in which the poet says, "The emperor becomes the moon because the entire court is white."
But the shades varied, borrowed from nature, where no two whites are the same.
There are five whites, essentially. The white of the August moon, the white of the conch shell, the white of the clouds when the rain is spent, the white of the surf of the sea, and the white of the jasmine flower.
And from these whites emerge a profusion of tones.
The dyers, the poets, the naikas on their own, we're exploring the different realms of white. Chikankari mein koi alag cheez khoj ke nikali, jamdani mein koi alag cheez nikali. Murmure ki safedi, makhaniya safedi, makke ki safedi. Wo ye cheezein hoti thi aur logon ke paas wo aankhein thi, wo dekhna pasand karte the aur in tamam safedi ke alag alag roopon ko apnana chahte the. Isiliye safed ye cheezein bani. अगर वो ना अपनाना चाहते हैं, अगर उन्हें कुछ सरोकार नहीं होता, तो ये सफ़ेद के इतने सारे वर्णिका भंग नहीं होते.
The jasmine or chamele, of which there are 8 varieties, flowers in the summer, as does the champa, juhi and harsingar.
You know, the most beautiful thing about flowers, the use of flowers in India, this Anand Krishnaji told me once. He said that the women of India wear flowers on the back of their hair so that they, when they leave their room, they leave their fragrance behind. The white of the flowers of the summer are again cooling.
As is white saddlewood paste applied to the forehead and conch shell bangles worn by married women in West Bengal.
এটা একটা রত্ন এটা হাতে পড়লে স্থিরতা হয়ে যায় যে কোনো মেয়ে ছেলে বিবাহের সময় এটা পরে দিলে সে স্থিরতা হয় সেই থেকে সাকাটা উৎপন্ন হয়.
The dupatta, chunri or scarf offers protection from the sun and in a variety of whites.
अलईपुरा से मदनपुरा नहीं दूर पिया लावे के जरूर पड़ी ना.
In the rich musical tradition of Banaras, this song reflects the desire of the nayika or heroine for a camphor color dupatta.
हो अनोखे कलगी होए चार टुके रंग मिले तो कपूरी ले लिया पिया. हाँ अलईपुरा से मदनपुरा नहीं दूर पिया लावे के जरूर पड़ी ना. अलईपुरा और मदनपुरा हमारे बनारस की दो बहुत ही मुख्य केंद्र है किंखा बिनाई के, और दोनों लगभग एक ही समय के आसपास दोनों स्थापित हुए हैं. मदनपुरा के जो बुनकर हैं वो दिल्ली से आए, अलीपुरा के बुनकर थे वो भी गुजरात से आए हुए थे, पर कुछ एक कारण ऐसा था कि इनके रस्मों लिबास कायदे मेल नहीं खाते थे, और इसीलिए एक लंबे समय तक दोनों परिवारों में शादियाँ भी नहीं हुई, पर फिर शादियाँ होने लगी. अब एक मदनपुरा की किसी बहुत अच्छे गिरस्त की बेटी ब्याह के गई है अलईपुरा में, और वहाँ भी उसका मन नहीं लगा. सावन आया है और वो अपने प्रीतम से कहती है कि मदनपुरा कोई बहुत दूर तो नहीं है, वहाँ पे जाओ और एक हमारे लिए चुनरी ले आओ और रंग मिले तो कपूरी ले लो.
From the beginning, poets, artists and filmmakers have used white as a metaphor to tell their stories. In Satyajit Ray's short film Pico, the color reflects innocence in the midst of betrayal.
A little boy is sent out into the vast garden of his home by his mother, who wants to get into bed with her adulterous lover. And there he goes into the garden, sketching all the flowers with the right colors. And suddenly he comes to this corner of the garden where all the flowers are white, and he calls out to his mother, "Mother, I can't find the right color for all the white flowers. Can I sketch them with the black pen?" And that seems to me such a wonderful moment about everything the film wants to say about innocence and life.
In songs from Hindi cinema, loneliness is often likened to a sheet of blank paper.
Ek shehnshah ne banwa ke hansi Taj Mahal.
The Taj Mahal remains the most popular symbol of love.
Mohabbat ki nishani di hai. Chaudhvi ka chand ho ya aftab ho.
And in this ode to beauty, the hero compares his beloved to a full moon.
La jawab ho.
The full moon is the brightest in the month of August, celebrated as Sharad Purnima, the night when Krishna is said to have played Ras Leela in the meadows of Vrindavan with Radha and the gopis. In the painted textiles of Pichwais which hang behind the image of Krishna as Srinath Ji in the temple of Nathdwara in Rajasthan, this union is portrayed in white.
Gopis are individual soul, individual jiva, and Krishna is Paramatma. This white is a kind of a symbol of meeting of individual jiva with the Paramatma.
In the Pichwai tradition, white is the color of celebration of Holi.
The white contains all the colors, and they come out in the Holi, you see how this white canvas gradually turns into pink, yellow and white powder, even black dots. This is a very, very early Nathadwara painting. There are bowls of gulal with its children of the Goswamis, and the Goswamis sprinkle over Srinathji. Gradually, ultimately, everything would become red. Like Om is a primordial sound, Nathadwara white is the color from which everything emerges.
Because it is the color of purity. Sanskrit poet and dramatist Kalidas, in his epic work Meghdoot, describes white as the color of hasya or laughter. When Ganga threatens to submerge all creation with the force of her flow, Shiva is asked to tame the river. He traps her in his locks. This makes Parvati jealous and amuses Ganga, whose laughter shows up on the surface of the water as white foam. Another story reveals that the Himalayas were created from Shiva's laughter.
Kalidasa in Meghdootam says, Trembakasya attahasaha. These Himalayas are only the concretization of the laughter of Shiva, because they are snow clad. Govinda Jai
Jai. But in this ashram for Hindu widows, white is the color of sorrow and renunciation, forced on them in the last 300 years, not by religion, but by man-made laws. Slowly as societies developed, white evolved from being the color of cotton and necessity to the color of myths and rituals linked to purity. Dhavala ya shubhra vastra vrata ya veena varadanda mandita kara ya shweta padmasana.
Ye jo shlok hai, it is ascribed to Agastya Muni and by scholars. और इस श्लोक में सरस्वती देवी, जिनको हम विद्या की देवी के रूप में हम पूजते हैं, उनका बहुत सुंदर ये वर्णन है. Her first description that we get in the Rigveda, we find her as a flowing river. And later on in the Veda itself, we find her as one who represents vak, one who represents speech, wisdom, enlightenment, gyan.
In her puja and of other gods in the Hindu pantheon, panchamitra or nectar is offered as prasad. All five elements which go into its making, curd, water, ghee, honey and milk, are white.
Whether you're looking at the ritualistic Hindu, or the wedding dress of the Christian, or the two cloths that are worn by the Muslims when they go to Makkah, or the Sikhs, it is always white.
Because every religion was founded on the tenet of compassion, reflected in the habits of nuns and monks. Satriya is a classical dance form performed by monks on the island of Majuli in Assam. Derived from the word satra, meaning monastery, it is a way of worship based on mythological dramas composed in the 16th century by the Vaishnav saint and social reformer Shankaradeva.
When I used to watch, sometimes when they take the rounds, and you find that everything is white, but white will immediately appeal to you. I have not seen so much white in other dance forms. One would always ask Guruji, he said, no, here we only use white because of the purity.
In Kathakali, the dance drama of Kerala, the monkey god Hanuman appears in white. The demonesses who live in the jungle are painted black.
Hanumana is brought in the white, you know, jacket, and it is made of wool. And he has also, his kiritam is also white. But that is what they say, it was the influence of the Portuguese who came there. So there was a maritime, transaction between Kerala and Portuguese. So that white influence had come. And also there is a significance of the color of Hanuman is white. For instance, in contrast to Hanumana, there is a Kari character which is black, for instance Hidimba. She is dressed completely in black. So the contrast is to show the sattvic quality of Lord Hanuman.
Because tribals and scheduled castes at the bottom of the caste hierarchy were considered impure. For centuries, Dalits have picked cotton but were denied the right to wear white or anything that was new because the Brahmins considered them impure.
Dalits were not allowed to actually wear any new clothes. And they were forced to wear the cast off clothes of their feudal lords and aristocratic classes. So they were actually using jhutan. That is what is recorded by Dr. Ambedkar, that they were not allowed to wear the just new clothes. They were forced to dirty it, muddy it, spoil it actually in mud, and then stitch it and then wear it.
The purity versus pollution narrative was dented by modernity. And the independence movement led by Gandhiji, who made white khadi the color of freedom and everyday life for all Indians.
I do not think he consciously chose white as a color, but he chose the simplest and the most basic fabric, which was uncolored, undyed, and therefore had to be white. And there was therefore an inbuilt austerity to it.
Today, white khadi dominates the public space and popular imagination as the color of politics.
मैं ये कहूँगा कि गांधी की खादी और आज के सियासत की खादी में फर्क ये है कि गांधी की खादी उनके खुद के हाथों से धुली जाती थी, उस पर कलफ नहीं चढ़ी थी, बल्कि उन्होंने एक बार एक सवाल के जवाब में कहा है, खादी को मैल पसंद नहीं, जल्दी उसको धो देना पड़ता है। तो आज या तो खादी पे कलफ चढ़ी होती है या खादी पे मैल, और दोनों कई बार साथ साथ होते हैं। वो पाखंड को बहुत आसानी से बहुत जल्दी दिखा देता है, बाकी रंग शोभा देते हैं, सफ़ेद दायित्व देता है।
That's why traditionally a crystal or sphatik was always embedded in the crown of rulers who dispensed justice.
The most sacred stone of India is crystal or sphatik, essentially because sphatik deflects light to the left. And I was told by Dr. Nagaswamy, who was the head of the archaeological department of the Tamil Nadu government for many, many years, that all crowns at the time of performing justice had at their center crystal, so that it would absorb the light of the sun and deflect it to the left, which is where the heart is.
In contemporary India, the color white has also been identified with success, honesty and hard work, and those who continue to seek the truth.
Ar safed mahal dikh raha bikham ka chadna hai wahan safed sej phoolon ki wahan. Kabir panthiyon mein vishesh roop se safed kapde pehante hain jo satya ka pratik hai. Kabir satya ke pradarshak ya satya ke anugami the jinhone keval saanch kaha, aur isliye un saanch ki baat jo hai wo is safed kapde उनका परिचायक है।
उड़ जाएगा, उड़ जाएगा, उड़ जाएगा। जग दर्शन का मेला, जग दर्शन का मेला। उड़ जाएगा, उड़ जाएगा हंस अकेला, उड़ जाएगा।